Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and nice to see a full house as always. Thank you very much for coming and spending some of your valuable time with us. So to start off, the good news is this year we've, with the support of Nations Trust Bank, who have been with us on many of our activities, this year we've decided that we'll run the whole year in this hall, because you know we'd like to keep enhancing the experience every year, and they've been very generous to support us on that journey, and hopefully we'll see a full hall every month like this. So I want to thank NTB, Teja is here, and the team, I think Adisha is somewhere here, hopefully. And let me just do a couple of announcements first. Right, the upcoming two Singharaja trips are full, but if anyone's interested in getting out there in February 24th, 25th, we are doing Bundala, and a lot of people have been showing a lot of interest in our excursion, so we have limited seats. If anyone's interested, please feel free to join us. Want to thank ProImage and Mohan, lots of support with video and on coverage of the past lectures and things like that. CJ is quite often here. I'm not sure if he's here today, but CJ and the Sarva team for a lot of creative support. We all enjoy a nice cup of Dilma tea as we go along, so thank you to Dilma. We have a couple of corporate sponsors who have helped us to kind of up the game in the work that we do every year, plus also help us fight the conservation battle, because this is not all about awareness. And so we have to thank TJ, Brandix, John Keel's Automation, and now you have a lot of the low-risk, the old versions online. For that, we have to thank Sanjay, right, Sanjay Lanka. As always, it's the time of the year when we have to knock on your door and remind you that's a new year, so please help us by paying your subs. Also, an appeal to lots of the older life members, because, you know, the life membership was relatively cheap, but you know, costs are going up, so if any of you can continue to give us some odd funds now and then, that's always welcome, right? We are still on a charge to kind of increase the number of new members, so we invite anyone in the audience, you can fill up a form, join us, and we'd like more and more people, you know, signing up. The bungalows have also been renovated, and so we'd invite many of you to kind of spend your time at our bungalows in Yala, Udavalave, and Vilpattu. With that, the next step, let me invite, we've just got the new lorries out, so can I have Ayandi, Rukshan, and of course Vindhya, who edits Varna and Varnam, to hand over the lorries to Teja, and I think Adisha is around, so could we have them over here and do a ceremonial quick handing over of the lorries before we get on to the main course. I see a number of regulars here, so we have lots of people who hear and follow us regularly, irrespective of the topic. But there are a lot more who are probably here because there's nothing as captivating as stealing a few minutes in the wild with our elusive leopard, right? And to do the honors today and tell us a story is Rukshan. I have a long history here. I'm going to keep it to a short few points, but Rukshan's fascination obviously began with a rug on the floor in the good old days, leopard skin, which is now frowned upon, but those were the times. And then, of course, next step was when his grandfather took him to the zoo. But subsequent to that, I think he and his brother hit Vilpattu in the 70s, and that's when he first saw his first leopard, and probably he says that's where his love affair began. Subsequent times, I think he spent quite a bit of time in Yala, but the leopards in Yala at that time were quite elusive. Any of you who have been in tourism and all in the good old days knew that you had a leopard icon in Vilpattu and an elephant icon in Yala, because that's what it used to be before times changed. So Rukshan subsequently got a few peeks at the leopards, but I think the turning point was in 97 at no less place than the Society Bungalow that he met Dr. Ravi and Jehan. And they were doing this interesting work on identifying leopards and all of that. And, you know, obviously they'd been impacted by Sriyani's work on establishing the different patterns. And of course, Sriyani went on to help us identify the subspecies. Can't forget Derniagala's work in the 50s, long before DNA was around, so the good old-fashioned way of doing it. But when Rukshan heard that they were pursuing doing a coffee table book, he jumped in with the idea and became part of that journey, spending as much as 6-7 nights continually a month on an ongoing basis with these two. And they spent many hours discussing leopards and observing them and all of that. And obviously that later led to the book, which was Harit's dream actually. And Jehan and Ravi saw it through. And Rukshan contributed in many ways, plus Dr. Sriyani and all of that. They later set up the Leopard Trust, and you know, as we know, the rest is history. But what was important was, while this was not a scientific book, there was so much of observation and patterns and photographs and things, which, you know, like the book that inspired them, The Leopards of Londolese, helped many people to understand lots of things about leopards. And you know, increasingly it's anecdotal and scientific information combined together which is helping us understand. So that's the background with which Rukshan has gathered hours and hours of time in the hot sun and shade and all of that. But Rukshan, hopefully the next hour is what matters most to us. And we look forward to being inspired and, you know, getting some insight beyond what we see when we hit the parks. And you can tell us what's behind that elusive leopard's mind. Rukshan, floor is yours.